the main stage of the Opera House. Let us commence, ladies and gentlemen, with Lot 663, a poster from this house's production of Hannibal by Shelley Moore.
Coming here.
Do I have 10 francs? 5 then. 5 AMB, 6 USC, 7, 7, 8, selling at 8 once, 8 twice, sold. To Raoul, the conditionnee. Thank you very much. Lot 664 then, ladies and gentlemen. A wooden pistol and 3 human skulls. From the 1831 production of Robert Le Diable by Meyerbeer.
Showing here.
10 francs for this. 10, thank you. 10 AMB. 10 francs still. 15, thank you, sir. 15 AMB. Going at 15. Your number, sir? Lot 665. A papier-mâché musical box. Inside, the figure of a monkey in Persian robes playing the cymbals. This item, discovered in the vaults of the theater, still in working order, ladies and gentlemen.
Showing him.
May I commence at 20 francs? Oh, come, come, ladies and gentlemen. 15 then. 15 I am bid. Thank you. 20.
25.
25 on my left. Thank you, madam.
30.
30. Selling at 30 francs then. 30 once. 30 twice. Oh, the 30 francs to the Vicomte de Chagny. Thank you once again, sir.
Leave it.
Thank you.
and find the land we love. That was marred by Roma's far-reaching
curse. No, signor! If you please, Rome. We say Rome, not the Roma.
This is the Roma. It's very hard
once
for
again,
me.
So please, signor. Rehearsals, as you see, are underway for a new production of Shalimar's Harlem. Ladies and gentlemen, some of you perhaps have already met Monsieur André and Monsieur Firmin.
Monsieur Lafayette, we are rehearsing! If you wouldn't mind waiting a moment.
My apologies, Monsieur Reyes. Proceed. Proceed!
Once again, Signor!
Signor!
Monsieur Reyes, our chief repetitor.
Sad to return.
Rather a tyrant, I'm afraid.
Sad to return and to find the land we love. Granted once more by Rome's far-reaching grasp. Tomorrow we shall break the chains of Rome.
Well, opposite Lord Carlotta.
Gentlemen, please! If you would kindly stand to one side.
And my apologies, Madame Giry. Madame Giry. Our ballet mistress. I don't mind confessing, Monsieur Femin. I shan't be sorry to be rid of the whole blessed business.
I keep asking you, Monsieur, why exactly are you retiring?
A particular pride here in the excellence of our ballet.
Christine Dyer! Concentrate, girl!
Dyer, curious name.
Swedish, and a promising dancer, Monsieur André. Always has her head in the clouds, I'm afraid.
Welcome to Hannibal's Lair!
Giudicelli, our leading soprano for 5 seasons now.
Of course, Signora. I have experienced all of your greatest roles.
And Signor Ubaldo Piangi, our principal tenor.
An honor, Signor.
Piacere. If I remember rightly, Alyssa has a rather fine aria in Act 3 of Hamlet. I wonder, Signora, if there's a personal favor you would oblige us with a private rendition? Unless, of course, Monsieur Rayet objects.
No. My manager commands.
Monsieur Rayet.
My diva commands. Will two bars be sufficient introduction?
Quite sufficient.
Signora.
No! Scusate. Ma quante volte devo ripetertelo a tempo moderato? Non mi piace!
Grazie.
Think of me. Think of me fondly when we've said
from who?
I don't know, sir.
Can you believe it? A full house, and we have to cancel!
Miss Dyer, any relation to the violinist?
My father, sir. Let her sing for you, monsieur. She has been well taught.
Very well.
From the beginning of the aria, then, mademoiselle.
Christine! from the shadows, distant from all the applause. I hear your voice in the darkness, yet the words aren't yours. Angel of music, guide and guardian, brought to me your healing.
I listen.
cast upon a vast glassy lake. There were candles all around, and on the lake there was a boat. And in the boat there was a man.
Those two fools who run my theater will be missing you.
Damnable! But they all walk out, this is damnable!
Henry, please don't shout it!
publicity, and the take is vast.
Free publicity!
But we have no cast.
But Andre, have you seen the queue?
It seems you've got one too. Dear Andre, what a charming gala. Christine enjoyed a great success. We were hardly bereft when Carlotta left. Otherwise, the chorus was entrancing, but the dancing was a lamentable mess.
Dear Fielder, just a brief reminder. My salary has not been paid. Send in care of the ghost by return of post. PTO.
Please turn over.
Oh. No one likes a debtor, so it's better when my orders are obeyed. Who would have a gall to send this? Someone with a purer brain. These are both psycho G.
Who the hell is he? Opera ghost!
It's really not amusing.
He's abusing our position.
In addition, he wants money.
He's a funny sort of spectre.
To expect a larger deal of nothing plainer, he is cleaning.
Where is she? You mean Carlotta, I mean Miss Taye. Where is she?
Well, how should we?
I want an answer. I take it that you sent me this note.
What's all this nonsense?
Of course not.
Don't look at us.
She's not with you then.
Of course not.
We're in the town, monsieur. Don't argue. Isn't this the letter you wrote?
And what is it that I meant to have wrote?
Written? Do not fear for Miss Taye. The angel of music has her under his wing. Make no attempt to see her again. Well, if you didn't write it, who did?
Where is he?
Oh, welcome back.
Your precious patron, where is he?
What is it now?
I have your letter. A letter which I'd rather have sent.
And did you send it?
Of course not. As if he would.
You didn't send it.
Of course not.
What's going on?
You dare to tell me that this is not the letter you sent.
And what is it that I meant to have sent? Your days at the opera populaire are numbered. Christine Taye will be singing on your behalf tonight. Be prepared for a great misfortune should you attempt to take her place. Far too many notes for my taste.
And most of them about Christine.
All we heard since we came is Miss Taye's name.
Miss Taye has returned.
In which case, I think our meeting is adjourned.
Where precisely is she now?
I thought it best that she went home. She needed rest.
May I see her?
No, monsieur. She will see no one.
Will she sing? Will she sing?
Here, I have a note.
Let me see it,
please. Gentlemen, I have now sent you several notes of the most amiable nature, detailing how my theater is to be run. You have not followed my instructions. I shall give you one last chance.
Christine Taye has returned to you, and I am anxious her career should progress. In the new production of Immuto, you will therefore cast Carlotta as the page boy, and put Miss Taye. The role of the page boy silent, which makes my passing in the world I hear. I shall watch the performance from my room, seat box 5, which will be empty for me.
Should these commands be ignored? A disaster beyond your imagination will occur. I remain, gentlemen, your obedient servant, O.G.
Christine!
Whatever next!
For the point of a Christine!
This is insane!
No, who sent this? The Vicomte her lover!
Indeed, can you believe this?
Carlotta will be playing the lead.
You don't deserve her.
It's useless to me to please. It's useless to me to please.
needs you.
We need you too.
Would you not rather have your precious little Angelou?
Signora, no. The world wants you. Prima donna, first lady of the stage, your devotees are on their knees to implore you.
Can you bow out when they're shouting your name?
Think of how they all adore you. Prima donna, enchant us once again.
Think of your muse.
And of the cues from the theatre. Can you deny us the triumph in store? See,
prima donna, once more.
Hide over there to observe her.
Why have you brought us here?
Don't take me back there!
You must return!
He'll kill me! His eyes will find me there! Those eyes that burn! And if he has to kill 1,000 men!
Forget this working nightmare!
The Phantom of the Opera!
That is a fable, but believe me, there is no Phantom of the Opera!
I thought you
shut up!
horses, lead with them at the door.
And soon you'll be beside me.
You'll guard me and you'll guide me.